What is Molluscum Contagiosum? Molluscum Contagiosum is an infection caused by a pox virus. The result of the infection is usually a benign, mild skin disease characterized by lesions that may appear anywhere on the body. Molluscum Contagiosum is a self-limited infection, which means it resolves by itself. The lesions are small, raised, and usually white, pink, or flesh-colored with a dimple or a pit in the center. It has a pearly appearance and is smooth and firm. In most people, the lesions range from about the size of a pinhead to as large as a pencil eraser, which is 2 to 5 millimeters in diameter. Mollusca may occur anywhere on the body, including the face, neck, arms, legs, abdomen, and genital area, alone or in groups. The lesions are rarely found on the palms of the hands or the soles of the feet. So who's at risk for Molluscum Contagiosum? Most commonly, children between the ages of 1 to 10, but it's not limited to just children. People are at increased risk for getting the disease if they have a weakened immune system, like from HIV infection, or if they're being treated for cancer. Their growths may look a little different. They could be larger and more difficult to treat. They may have atopic dermatitis. This is a risk factor for getting Molluscum Contagiosum due to frequent breaks in the skin. People with this condition also may be more likely to spread Molluscum Contagiosum to other parts of their body for the same reason. And lastly, people who live in a warm, humid climate where living conditions are crowded. So how is it transmitted? It's transmitted primarily direct person to person and through physical contact. Contaminated fomites. Inanimate objects that can become contaminated with virus, such as clothing and towels, bathing sponges, pooled equipment, and toys. Sexual contact, shaving and electrolysis. Molluscum can be spread to other parts of their body by touching or scratching a lesion and then touching their body somewhere else. This is called auto-inoculation. The virus remains in the top layer of the skin, called the epidermis, and does not circulate throughout the body. Once the lesions are gone, the virus is gone, and you cannot spread it to others. What is the incubation period for Molluscum Contagiosum? This is between 2 weeks and 6 months, and the signs and symptoms include small, pearly papules with a central depression whose core may be expressed, producing a white, cheesy material. The lesions average 2 to 5 millimeters in size. It's usually painless, but may become inflamed, red, and swollen. The papules usually disappear spontaneously within 6 to 12 months, but may take as long as 4 years to resolve. Most cases occur in children over 1 year of age, with only one known case reported in an infant at 7 days postpartum. Molluscum Contagiosum diagnosis. Diagnosis is made on the appearance. Molluscum Contagiosum lesions have recently come to be classified in one of three ways. 1, the commonly seen skin lesions found largely on the faces, trunks, and limbs of children. 2, the sexually transmitted lesions found on the abdomen, inner thighs, and genitals of sexually active adults. And 3, the diffuse and recalcitrant eruptions of patients with AIDS or other immunosuppressive disorders. The period of communicability is unknown, but probably as long as the lesions are persistent. How do we treat Molluscum Contagiosum? Because Molluscum Contagiosum is self-limited in healthy individuals, treatment may be unnecessary. Issues such as lesion visibility, underlying atopic disease, and the desire to prevent transmission may prompt therapy. Treatment is usually recommended if lesions are in the genital area, on or near the penis, vulva, vagina, or anus. Treatment options. Physical removal requires a trained healthcare provider and may require local anesthesia and can result in post-procedural pain, irritation, and scarring. Cryotherapy, curettage, laser therapy, and oral therapy. Another is oral cimetidine, and it's been used as an alternative treatment for small children who are either afraid of the pain associated with cryotherapy, curettage, and laser therapy, or because the possibility of scarring is to be avoided. Facial mollusca do not respond as well as lesions elsewhere on the body. How do we prevent it? The best way to avoid getting molluscum is by following good hygiene habits. Remember that the virus lives only in the skin, and once the lesions are gone, the virus is gone and you cannot spread the virus to others. So remember to wash your hands. Keeping your hands clean is the best way to avoid molluscum infection, as well as many other infections. Hand washing removes germs that may have been picked up from other people or from surfaces that have germs on them. Don't scratch or pick at molluscum lesions. It's important not to touch, pick, or scratch skin that has any lesions at all. Not only your own, but others as well. Picking and scratching can spread the virus to other parts of the body and makes it easier to spread the disease to other people too. Keep molluscum lesions covered. It's important to keep the area with molluscum lesions clean and covered with clothing or a bandage so that others do not touch the lesion and become infected. Do remember to keep the affected skin clean and dry. In preventing molluscum contagiosum, be careful during sports activities. Don't share towels, clothing, or other personal items. People with molluscum should not take part in contact sports like wrestling, basketball, and football unless all lesions can be covered by clothing or bandages. Activities that use shared gear like helmets, baseball gloves, and balls should also be avoided unless all lesions can be covered. Swimming should also be avoided unless all lesions can be covered by watertight bandages. Personal items such as towels, goggles, and swimsuits should not be shared. Other ways to avoid sharing your infection: do not shave or have electrolysis on areas with lesions. Don't share personal items such as unwashed clothes, hairbrushes, wristwatches, and bar soap with others. And if you have lesions on or near the penis, vulva, vagina, or anus, avoid sexual activities until you see a healthcare provider.